Hello.
Welcome to Oxford Heirlooms. In this video, I'm going to be working at the ironing board because I need to prepare my pattern pieces for hemming. Okay, so I have cut out there's two of them in this layer, two 16 inch squares that I'm going to fold in 1/4 inch and 1/4 inch to make a 15 inch square napkin. So let me unpin my pattern piece and put my pattern piece off to the side. Oops, I got one more pin in here. Happens to me all the time. Okay, all right, so I'm gonna start with one at a time. So let me set one of my napkin pieces off to the side. Okay, now what I'm gonna do is I need to fold this hem in 1/4 inch and then another 1/4 inch. And then after I get that done, I need to go to the sewing machine and actually miter my corners. So I'm gonna start just by pressing one side at a time, 1/4 inch. This doesn't have to be perfect. I tend to, when I make napkins for myself, I kind of eyeball this. Since I'm consistent in what I tend to eyeball, I mean, it tends to work out pretty well. Okay, so this is the second side. This is the third side. And this is the fourth side. Okay, now I need to do another 1/4 inch going around each side so that it'll already be folded in for me. Okay, so this is the first side. This makes for just a narrow little hem. And I know some people like to use sergers on napkins, but I don't like serger sewing machines. I don't like the way it looks. My sister gave me a serger and I have literally never turned it on and used it, much less put thread in it or anything. It still sits in my closet. Maybe one of these days I'll use it, but not today. Okay, so I'm pressing these to give me a guide for when I miter my corners. And I'll show you how I miter these corners in just a minute. Okay, one more side to fold it a second time. And then I will move to the sewing machine. Okay, so I have folded down by 1/4 inch each side 2 times. Okay, so now I'm gonna move over to my sewing machine, so I'll be right back. Okay, so I've been to the ironing board and I have pressed this little hem in place 2 times, 1/4 inch and then another 1/4 inch around all 4 sides of the napkin. Now I need to, at these bottom corners, I need to miter the edge so that it will lay flat and I can hem it. And let me show you what I mean. I've already hemmed one. So as you can see, in this underside bottom corner, there's a little 45 degree angle seam, followed by a quarter inch hem with a tiny little seam line holding it in place. Okay, so how we do this? Part of how we do this is we start by folding it a quarter of an inch and a quarter of an inch, which we've already done. Okay, now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna come back and I'm gonna unfold it one time, but I'm gonna leave it folded in by the first 1/4 inch. Then I'm gonna fold my fabric, each corner, into a diagonal angle. Fold it on the diagonal, lining up the two sides, and that forms a 45 degree angle. Okay, can you see what I've done here? Okay, now in order to keep that into place, I'm gonna pin that temporarily. Okay, now this little corner, I can pull that little corner out. Just make sure the fabric is lined up. Okay, now using my little drafting triangle, I'm gonna draw a line that's, I need to move my pen. I need to draw a line that's perpendicular to the diagonal. Okay, so I'm gonna use the little 90 degree angle of my drafting triangle. And I've got my napkin pinned at a 45 degree angle. I'm gonna line the side up with the diagonal, line up the edge of the drafting triangle, and right here where the first 1/4 inch meets up with the diagonal line, I'm gonna draw another diagonal line. Okay, can you see what I've done? I've got, at a 90 degree angle, I've got a little line drawn that's gonna be my 45 degree interior angle. And you can finger press that because we're gonna press it with the iron later on. That's the nice thing about Swiss batiste, you can finger fold it. Okay, now coming into my sewing machine, I have my machine set for a straight stitch with white thread in my machine. And I'm gonna just go backward and forward a couple of times on that tiny little diagonal line that I drew. Clip my threads. And then I'm gonna come in and I'm gonna clip that about a 16th of an inch away from the line that I just sewed on. So I can turn this to the outside now. And you can see I have the beginnings of my little mitered corner and 45 degree angle. I'm gonna use my little loop turner to push that little corner out sharp, and then you can see it forms a nice little mitered corner, which I'm gonna hem in a minute. But I need to do my other three corners on this napkin, so I'll be right back. Okay, so I've got each of the four corners mitered, and since I already folded it the second time, I mean, you could pin this hem down if you wanted to, but I tend to not do that. So I'm going to start with a straight stitch in the middle of one of the sides. Drop your needle in so that you can tell that you're right next to the fold of the fabric and not going off of it, and start to hem your napkin. Don't go too quickly. because you want to stay close to that fold without coming off of it and without migrating too far away from it either. Okay, when I get close to the edge, I'm going to start going real slow, and then I'm going to do it with my hand a couple of times until I just get right in that corner. I'm going to drop my needle all the way down, lift up my presser foot, rotate the napkin 90 degrees, and then proceed to sew the next side. And we'll do this on all four of the corners. We'll drop the needle in, pick up the presser foot, rotate 90 degrees, lower the presser foot, and continue sewing. When you get back around to where you started, just overlap by about a half an inch and then clip your threads. So this will take me a minute to get the entire napkin hemmed. Okay, so that napkin is now hemmed, and it has beautifully mitered corners, okay, with no raggedy edges. And these napkins are ready to be embroidered. So in the next video, I'll show you how I set up to do the hand embroidery on the napkins. And I will even show you a few of my little embroidery stitches that I'll be doing, because there aren't that many. There are French knots, lazy daisy loops, and some running stitches. So it's really easy embroidery, but I think it's going to be really pretty on my napkins to match my grandmother's china. But preparing the pattern pieces and hemming the napkins was what we were doing today. Thank you.